using the normal distribution to approximate a binomial distribution. The normal distribution mean NP and variant NPQ can be used to approximate the binomial distribution. Okay, we only use the normal distribution to approximate a binomial distribution when n greater than 50. Because when n greater than 50, we cannot read from table. So, mu or equal to ex or mean equal to n times p and variant equal to n times p times q, where q is 1 minus p. Okay, continuity correction. The binomial distribution applies to discrete random variable, whereas the normal distribution applies to continuous random variable. So we need to make some correction for continuity as follow. Okay, example, if x has a binomial with n equal to 80 and p equal to 0.3, use the normal distribution to approximate the binomial distribution. Okay, look at the question and we see that n equal to 80, so n greater than 50, so we must use normal distribution. So mean equal to 80 times 0.3, we get 24. Variant equal to 80 times 0.3 times 0.7 equal to 16.8. So we write x has a normal distribution with mean 24 and variance 16.8. For A, Px equal to 14. Do continuity correction. Okay, with this diagram, we can understand better. Okay, we draw x equal to 14. The graph is only one line, so no area. So we must add 0.5 to 14. We get 14.5 and minus 0.5. We get 13.5, so 9 become an area. We can write px greater than or equal to 13.5 and less than equal to 14.5. Okay, we change to z. Okay, we get pz greater than or equal to negative 2.56 and less than equal to negative 2.31. Okay, we draw the graph for z distribution and draw line negative 2.56 and negative 2.31, and the area is between this line. This value is in negative side, so we change to positive side. So we write pz greater than or equal to 2.31, less than or equal to 2.56, and we take pz greater than 2.31 minus pz greater than 2.56 and read from table. We get 0.0104 minus 0.00523 and the answer is 0.00517. Okay, for b, px greater than or equal to 15. Okay, we do continuity correction. Okay, we draw line and we know the area is on the right side because x greater than or equal to 15. So we add 0.5, we get 15.5, and minus 0.5, we get 14.5. p x greater than or equal to 15 mean 15 must be in the answer. Okay, if we take x greater than or equal to 15.5, 15 is not in our answer, so take px greater than or equal to 14 as answer. So px greater than or equal to 14.5, we will change to z. Okay, we get pz greater than negative 2.31 with picture wise, and sketch area greater than negative 2.31, and the area is greater than 0.5, and the line in the left side, so we must change to the right side. So we can take 1 minus pz greater than or equal to 2.31 and read from the graph, and the answer is 0.9896. Okay, C px greater than 13. Okay, we do continuity correction. We don't want 13 as a answer, so we take px greater than or equal to 13.5. Okay, change to z. So we get pz greater than or equal to negative 2.56, and picture wise, and we change to right side, so the answer 1 minus pz greater than equal to 2.56, and we get 0.99477 is an answer. Okay, D, px less than 17. Okay, do continuity correction. 17 shouldn't be in our answer, so we take px less than 16.5. Okay, change to z, and we get p less than negative 1.83, and picture wise negative 1.83, and so we change to right side. We can write pz greater than or equal to 1.83, so the answer is 0.0336. E, px greater than or equal to 11, less than equal to 16. We do continuity correction. 11 must be in our answer, so we take 10.5, and 16 also must be in our answer, so we take 16.5. This is our picture for this question, and change to z, get pz greater than negative 3.29, less than negative 1.83. okay, and we change to the right side, so we take pz 1.83 minus pz greater than 3.29. okay, read from table, and we get the answer 0.0331. okay, e, px greater than or equal to 13 and less than equal to 29. okay, 13 must be in our answer, so we take 12.5, and 29 shouldn't be in our answer, so we take x less than 28.5. okay, so we change to z, we get z greater than or equal to 2.81, less than 1.1. okay, from the graph we can take 1 is the area for the whole graph minus p z greater than 2.81 minus pz greater than 1.1. okay, we read from table, and we get 0.86182.